adult. No nachos on the tender gums. And Claudette Stefanian, like the sun rising over the mountains, is in the newsroom. Claudette, good morning.
Good morning. Well, Dean, you're too kind, because I had a bunch of delays, flight cancellations yesterday, so I was a little bit worried about this morning, so bear with me.
Oh, where were you coming from?
I was coming from Denver, and my goodness, I was witnessing firsthand these cancellations, delays. I'm definitely not used to it. So I'm kind of seeing what some people have been seeing this summer. Not fun, Dean. Let me tell you, not fun.
All right, but you're here. You made it. You're here. You're here with us to let us know everything else that's going crazy in the world today.
Oh, yeah. Roaring. Let's get this going.
All right. Shall we begin? Shall we try? And you know what? Let's just dive right into it. Melody, welcome home.
I would love to talk to you about my brick wall. I'm getting a concrete cinder block wall built. I've had 4 to 5 estimates done, and the estimates have been done within the last 3 months. And the weird thing is that the three different estimates from $7,000 up, or from $8,000 up to $17,000 for a cinder brick wall that's only 8 foot tall and 88 feet long.
Okay. Is it retaining anything? In other words, is it doing the work of holding back soil, or is it just a freestanding 8 foot wall?
No, it has to be a retaining wall. It's the concrete wall from one backyard neighbor to the other.
Okay, the concrete,
so
and it's 88. Yeah, how much soil is it retaining of the 8 feet?
You know what? I don't know how far they have to dig down to put it in, to put the post in. I don't know.
Okay.
That's a good question.
It is a good question, and I'll tell you why. Because the difference, Melanie, between a retaining wall and a just a garden wall, okay, has nothing to do with the materials that it's made out of. Has nothing to do with the fact that that it's cinder block. Has nothing to do with the height. The real money, the cost of a cinder block wall in a yard really gets revved up and cranked up once we're getting into the realm of retaining. That's because whatever portion of soil is being held back on one side of the wall versus the void or the absence of soil on the other side of the wall, that portion of the wall has to have reinforced rebar in it. It has to have an extended engineered footing or footer down at the base to keep it from rolling over, and so on and so forth. So the real costs of the wall are completely determinant upon how much retaining it's doing. You could have an 8 foot tall wall that's only retaining 2 feet of soil at the bottom, and that is what we would call a basic non-engineered retaining wall. In fact, in most jurisdictions, you can go up 3 feet of soil retention without getting engineering on the wall. So once you get above that, though, you know, if the wall is holding back 8 full feet of soil or 6 feet of soil or 5 feet of soil, that's where it gets confusing. And as to why does this cost so much? The other question I've got for you, oop, look at the time. Okay, I've got to finish up this one quick. The other question I've got for you, though, is if it is doing the job of retaining, do we have engineering on it? That could be an explanation of why you're getting such radically different quotes from different masons, because we've got to give them a plan, and we don't want to leave them guessing as to how much steel, how much concrete, because the portion of the wall that's retaining has to have extra steel. The cells of the cinder blocks have to be completely grouted. Everything above the soil line doesn't even have to have concrete grouted into the cells. And so there's a tremendous amount of material differential between the two, below soil line, above soil line. So we got to make sure, number one, that we know exactly what it's retaining. Number two, if it needs engineering, we need that engineering. We need somebody other than the brick masons to tell us what it is that this wall has to be. There has to be a plan, an approved plan for it. And then when you start handing that out to bid, you should find more consistent pricing. Now, you should. That doesn't mean that you're not going to find a big variance between, you know, one end of the pricing spectrum to the other. But the majority of bids should settle into the same zone. So when you see everything is just completely willy-nilly, chances are we might not be giving enough direction to the mason. So that's my best advice for you, Melanie. Double check your engineering. Make sure that they're all working off of the same spec instead of assuming one guy to the next what actually has to go inside that wall. Great call to get us started off. More of your calls, all morning long when we return. I'm so glad you joined me this morning. So much more to come. You're home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Claudette Stefani has the news.
Court has rejected a petition to block Governor Newsom's school mask mandate. The CDC is recommending older Americans and those with compromised immune systems to avoid cruise ships, even if they've been vaccinated. The new guidance also applies to women who are pregnant or who are recently pregnant. Thousands of people have been evacuated from Afghanistan by U.S. troops. President Biden says withdrawing troops from Afghanistan was the right thing to do. An update on the 57 next.
So ever since Duffy Power Services, the generator people, have become a sponsor here at KFI, which, by the way, I am so thrilled. I love these folks at Duffy. I've been getting a lot of questions about how home backup generators work. So here is my quick explanation. Duffy is going to evaluate your home. Then they're going to hook you up with the perfectly sized generator to meet all of its power needs. Then, once you're all set up, when the next outage occurs, it's very simple. Everybody around you loses power, and your generator automatically takes over, and life continues uninterruptedly. There may be a flicker in the lights, and that's it. When the power comes back on, the generator knows that too, turns itself off. It's just that easy. What's also easy, 0% interest financing, payments as low as $72 a month, home emergency power is totally affordable. Now, the pandemic has everything in short supply, so don't wait. Call today. So Duffy can make sure your life, your comfort, your safety won't be interrupted during the next outage or any of the ones after that. Dial #250 on your cell and say Duffy Power. #250, Duffy Power, or find Duffy on the web at DuffyPower.com. That's DuffyPower.com.
Southland weather from KFI, partly cloudy skies for today, highs from the low to mid-70s, at the beaches to around 80 inland. From your Southern California Toyota dealer, we've got trouble on the 57.
Diamond Bar on the northbound side of the 57 before Diamond Bar Boulevard. It's a fatal crash investigation still taking away three right lanes. It's got you back up starting at Tonner Canyon Road. In Orange, 22 East connector to the 5 and 57 North shut down due to a crash. It's got you just a bit slow from Bristol and Fillmore on the westbound side of the 210. Rockford to the 5. Caltrans has all lanes shut down all weekend long till around 5 o'clock Monday morning. Use Foothill Boulevard instead. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robert Bucky.
This report is sponsored by Staples Stores. Staples Connect has amazing prices for everything on your back-to-school list. Right now, Crayola 12-count colored pencils, 10 plus 2 Crayola marker bonus packs, and Staples 2-pack scissors are just 97 cents each. Offer ends 9/18. Limit 30 on Crayola, limit 6 on scissors. Staples.
Prescription products require an online consultation. Restrictions apply. See website for full details and important safety information.
My husband's ED was affecting our marriage. Him was our answer. Hims connected my husband with a licensed provider online. He got medication to treat his ED at a fraction of the price of the name brand, delivered right to our door. Thanks to Hims, we got our intimacy and our marriage back.
Right now, get your first online provider's visit free when you go to forhims.com/joy. forhims.com/joy.
Have you wanted to speak a new language but thought it'd be too difficult or take too much time? Then try Babbel. In just 15 minutes a day, Babbel teaches you conversations that you will actually use. With 14 languages and lesson topics like travel, business, relationships, and more, you'll learn what matters most to you. Babbel. Language for life. Learn a new language with ease. Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's Babbel.com.
This is Leland Smith, owner of Service Champions Plumbing, Heating, and AC. You might find this hard to believe, but the thing that makes me happiest is when my customers' air conditioners don't break down. That's right, we love not fixing air conditioners. We're first and foremost a maintenance company. We catch problems before they happen, when they're tiny and inexpensive. We only charge $88 for our precision tune-up and professional cleaning, and our goal is to catch every single problem and make your AC last longer and run more efficiently. That's why we even guarantee our tune-ups. If your unit breaks down this season, we'll refund your $88 or credit it towards the repair. That's how serious we are about not fixing air conditioners. Call Service Champions to schedule your $88 tune-up at 833-777-7777 or find us online at servicechampions.com.
Service Champions, floating, heating,
Did you know the arrow in Amazon's logo represents A to Z? Maybe the My Computer Career logo should represent unemployed to employed. Ryan was out of work when he started classes in March. In September, he started his IT career working for Amazon, making more money than he ever thought possible. Here's a prime opportunity. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and take the free career evaluation today. You can start your new life as an IT pro in as little as 4 months. It's not rocket science. It's mycomputercareer.edu.
Some people treat investing like a game, but Marcus by Goldman Sachs approaches investing in a smart way with digitally managed portfolios that leverage Goldman Sachs strategies. So, do you want to play games or do you want your money to work smart? You can money. Visit Marcus.com to learn more about saving, borrowing, and investing from Marcus by Goldman Sachs.
Investing involves risk and investments may lose value. Brokerage and investment advisory services by Goldman Sachs and Company, LLC. Member FINRA, SIPC. Lending and deposits products provided by Goldman Sachs Bank USA. Member FDIC.
In 1775, the patriot Patrick Henry said, "Give me liberty or give me death." Hello, I'm John Okoyan, owner of Rooter Hero Plumbing. Today, I feel it has become, take my liberties, just keep me safe. My late father cherished the freedoms our nation's founders fought for. Still, he would have gotten vaccinated just to be able to work long hours to provide for his family. He would have done whatever it takes, mandate or not. That's who my dad was. As we approach Labor Day, there are less people in the workplace. I feel for restaurant owners, mom-and-pop bakeries, venues, and retail stores who are struggling to stay open. At Rooter Hero, we are blessed to have men and women who will do whatever it takes to help you. Our team worked through all of 2020, and they are here for you in 2021. It's your trust in us that keeps Rooter Hero Plumbing going. Thank you.
CL102-8886.
There's never been a better time to switch to Spectrum Mobile. You could save hundreds of dollars on your mobile bill. Plus, there are no added taxes, hidden fees, and no contracts. Try the Spectrum Mobile Savings Calculator today, and in three easy steps, you'll see how much you could save by switching. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save. Spectrum Internet required. Savings may vary. Restrictions apply. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save for details.
For official rules and more information about contests on this station, go to KFIAM640.com/rules.
Well, hey, 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 how are you today? Leo Laporte here, the tech guy. It's the dog days of summer. Not much happens in the tech industry at the end of August, but everybody's getting ready for a big September. New phones, new devices, lots to talk about, maybe even some new computers from all the big companies. And if you're having trouble with your computers, suffering, wilting under the summer heat, I'm here for you. I'll be here this weekend and every weekend. Come by and visit, won't you? I'll be looking for you. Leo Laporte, the tech guy.
Leo Laporte, this morning at 11. KFI AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
Sharp, the house whisperer. You're listening to Home, where every week we help you better understand that place where you live. It's an all calls weekend here at Home, so give me a call. We've got room on the board for you. The number to reach me, 833-2-ASK-DEAN. Misty is standing by to take your call. 833-2-ASK-DEAN. Anything you want to talk about regarding your home,
design question, construction issue, DIY concern, whatever it may be, or anything in between, give me a call and let's talk. Maybe I can help you out. All right, back to the phones. Jay, welcome home.
Hey, Dean, thanks for taking my call. I'm a big fan of your show.
Oh, thanks so much. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning to you. I had a question about an ADU. I'm looking at putting one in my backyard, and I've been told that the biggest you can go is half the size of your house. Is that right?
I'm not sure. And I'll tell you why. Because here's what's happened with ADUs. The state, you know, just a handful of years ago, 5 years ago, the idea of doing an ADU in certain cities and certain counties was tough. It was tough because certain cities, not unlike the one I live in, had an attitude towards ADUs that was like, well, you know, if we allow that to happen, a certain kind of people will start living here. Meaning renters, and so they were very reticent to allow ADUs, and they had made some I think ridiculous kind of parameters around how big an ADU can be. Then the state of California got involved because seeing ADUs as one potential remedy to help the housing crisis. So the state, as of a few years now, has mandated to every single city, every single county, you must allow ADUs, and you must allow ADUs under certain parameters. You must require no more than a 4-foot setback from property lines. ADUs have to be allowed, and I believe this is right, you have to check me on it, but ADUs have to be allowed up to a minimum of, I believe, 600 square feet, I think. But then, after that, it has been left up to individual cities to determine what their max size is. So I know that there are towns out there that have specifically said no more than half the size of the house. And, you know, that would make sense. It's hard to imagine getting a permit for an ADU that's 10,000 square feet when you live in a 2,000 square foot house. That's not an accessory dwelling unit. That's the primary unit. So so my answer to you, Jay, is that you've got, in every situation, you've got to check with your local municipality. That was just the long explanation of why. Every city is under a mandate to have a minimum that they have to allow. But as far as the maximum, check with your town. I think here, out in the Thousand Oaks Westlake area, I don't think it's up to half the size of the house. I think our limit is actually much shorter than that. It's something like, I don't know, it's more than that, like 700-800 square feet, something like that, regardless of how big the house is. So check with your local municipality, you will find out. But just know this, they have to give you permission to do an ADU up to a certain size because it's out of their hands. The state of California has taken it out of their hands. And that, in my opinion, for once, is a really, really good thing coming from the top, trickling down into local municipalities. Okay? Thanks, Jay. Excellent question. Thank you for your call. When we come back, we're just going to keep diving in more and more and more of your calls. I'm here to answer them today. Your home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer, Claudette Stefania.
Orange County Sheriff's deputies have arrested a man who allegedly got through a security checkpoint at John Wayne Airport and then stole a car, causing an airport to shut down. This happened last night. Flights in and out of the airport were stopped for nearly 2 hours. The guy was found in the ceiling of a terminal and arrested. The state Supreme Court has rejected a petition to block Governor Newsom's school mask mandate. Lucy Board of Education Vice President Dr. Ken Williams says the petition was about Newsom abusing power, not about masks.
The actual Constitution says that these emergency powers need to be terminated as soon as possible. And the hospitalization rates are nowhere near what they were in 2020.
The board had previously claimed kids can be harmed by wearing masks.
Newsom says the court decision this week reaffirms the state's strategy to keep kids safe with the mask mandate. Vice President Harris will hit the campaign trail in California to support Governor Newsom. The former California senator will visit next weekend to support Newsom in the recall election on September 14th. Harris and Newsom are longtime friends and allies from their early days in San Francisco Bay Area politics. Harris's arrival is designed to generate enthusiasm for Newsom's campaign, which will rely on a strong turnout from Democrats. We've got trouble on the 10.
Colton on the eastbound side of the 10 before Rancho Avenue. It's a crash block in a couple of lanes there. That's got you jammed back before Pepper Avenue. On the westbound side of the 10, as you head towards Vineyard, there was a full closure. They picked up those cones now. You're moving well as you head towards the 57. Diamond Bar on the northbound side of the 57 before Diamond Bar Boulevard. It's still three white lanes that are shut down for a fatal crash investigation. Slow drive starting at Tonner Canyon. And in Fillmore on the westbound side of the 210, Roxford to the 5. Caltrans has all lanes closed until Monday morning around 5 o'clock. Use Foothill Boulevard instead. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robert Bucky.
Oh, this is me. Of course it is. Whenever there's dead air, Dean is responsible, I'm sure. If you have decided to sell your house, I know it is tempting to just list it as is, or even take one of those cash-out deals that you hear so much about. But why sell yourself short when making just the right upgrades is going to maximize the sale value? You mean like flipping our home, Dean? Okay, we don't have the expertise or the cash to do that. I know. But the good people at Revive do. Revive knows exactly what to change on your home, what to spend, where to spend it. They will manage everything and front all the costs. Yeah, they front the costs. They get paid back from escrow, but the profit gained is all yours. How much? The average client makes over 200% profit on what Revive invests on their behalf. So this is a no-brainer. Reach out to iloverevive.com today and see if your home qualifies. So, to be clear, to make the most from the sale of your home, go to iloverevive.com, iloverevive.com.
And as you can see, I just followed in Dean's footsteps, so you're not alone. Southland weather from KFI, partly cloudy skies. For today, highs from the low to mid-70s. At the beaches, around 80 inland. Highs in the upper 70s to mid-80s in the valleys. Highs from 76 to 81 in the inland OC. Highs from 81 to 86 in the IE. Temperatures should stay around the 70s and 80s for the early part of the week, and then we should see those temperatures increase slightly by Wednesday. We leave local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Claudette Stefanian.
A lower mortgage rate can make a noticeable difference on your budget. It's true. You could be saving hundreds of dollars a month simply by refinancing to one of these incredibly low rates. Think of how much that can help. Then pick up the phone and call American Financing. And do it now before rates get any higher. I mean it. Rates are expected to rise later this year. You really should not miss out on what's available now. After all, it only takes a 10-minute call to get started. You'll get a free, no-obligation mortgage review, which will tell you if you can save up to $1,000 a month without resetting your term. You can choose any term 10 years and over. So don't put this off any longer. Call American Financing right now at 800-777-8109. That's 800-777-8109. Or visit AmericanFinancing.net. American Financing, NMLS 182334, NMLSConsumerAccess.org.
I know it's National Happiness Happens Month, but just between you and me, happiness is always happening at Morongo. So what are you waiting for? And now, the top five reasons to visit Morongo. Number five.
Hydrate, illuminate, or rejuvenate. Get great deals on all our signature services at Sage Spa.
Number four.
Pizza perfection at Good Times Cafe. Gouda cheese, your favorite toppings, and that crust is a must.
Three.
Keep it cool giveaway. You can get a roomy 45-can collapsible cooler when you earn 500 points on your rewards card, the 23rd or 24th.
Number two.
Come alive with live bands every weekend at the Sideline Stage. Latin, rock, funk, and soul, all at the Sideline Bar.
And the number one reason.
King of Thieves giveaway. Four winners every every hour, get a chance to steal away up to $2,000 cash. Play your favorite games with your rewards card Fridays, 5 p.m. to 2 a.m.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good times.
Live.
KFI AM 640.
Local.
And I'm our radio station.
KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. You are home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Hey, welcome to our fine program, and welcome to our All Calls weekend. It's been a few weeks, been about 8 weeks or so since we've taken nothing but calls, so it is time. Time to do it. That's what we're doing this morning. The number to reach me at, 833-2-ASK-DEAN. 833-2-ASK-DEAN. Give me a call. Anything. A construction issue, design issue, DIY question, whatever it may be. Anything that I can help you out regarding your home. All right, back to the phones. Kathy, welcome home.
I have some questions. We've had a contractor out to our house because we'd like to open our kitchen up, and it brought up questions that we need help answering. So we live in a house that was built in the 40s. It's got character like. You walk in the front door, there's a big inset bookcase. To the left is the dining room, which has floor-to-ceiling opening, so not like most houses where there's that archway. But then you hit the kitchen, and the kitchen has three doors in it, and it's tiny. And so We learned from the contractor that we can take both dining room walls out, the one that goes into the kitchen on one side and the one that goes into a pantry area to the back door on the other. So my first question is, we have to choose between a peninsula and an island. So if we did the peninsula, it would likely come from the back door straight out about 5 feet, but that would only leave 5 feet, which is just enough room for the kitchen sink and the dishwasher, which in one way in my head feels too small. If we were to do the island, we have 11 feet from the edge of the counter to the wall on the back of the bookcase.
Okay, I'm trying to imagine it here. So the question is, which should you do?
Is there a too small area for an island? The reason we were thinking of the peninsula was to keep the area more open, but if 11 feet is enough to put us, we're only 1,200 square feet, so it's not a big house. So is there small of an island that's just too small to put in?
Okay, so here are the general guidelines for peninsula versus island. And number one, even though you're taking down walls, you don't want to lose necessarily the identity of the dining room area. So you want to make sure that you're not pushing the kitchen so far into the dining room that you're encroaching in it and that it no longer is a defined dining room space. If we're talking about peninsulas, quite often people are setting up peninsulas to have seating on the other side. So on a seating side of a peninsula, you've got to allow for the depth of the chair. We normally allow for 3 feet off of the edge of the peninsula back. Not because chairs are that deep, but because once you've actually got somebody sitting there and they've pushed their seat back and the ability to kind of walk around the back side of them, you need about roughly, 3 feet or so in order to make that feasible. When it comes to the island, the real critical question on the island is what kind of pathways it's creating inside the kitchen itself. Now, technically, and I'm going to, let me underscore this 800 times, technically code for pass-through area is, I believe, still sitting at 32 inches. That is woefully undersized. That is just a technical requirement for the ability for people to move through that space. The minimum space that you need, walk space, on both sides, all ends, all four sides of an island, is 3 feet. That's the minimum. Okay, we just start there. And if there's something like a dishwasher involved where the island is encroaching on the dishwasher space, imagine opening up the dishwasher
If it's only a 3 foot wide space, you're going to have to stand to the side of the dishwasher. You may not have the luxury of walking around the dishwasher. That blocks off that pathway. So 3 feet is the minimum. So when you're figuring out your island space, you got to figure, okay, if I take the entire width here, okay, and I don't know if I'm reading it entirely correctly here in my brain, but let me just use it as an example regardless. If we take 11 feet, okay, if we've got 11 feet from cabinet line to edge of kitchen or, you know, otherwise, and we're going to account for 3 feet of space, we've got to take away 6 feet immediately, okay? Now, I'm thinking that in a small kitchen, that 11 feet is not all walk space for island space, but nevertheless, whatever the width of the kitchen is, let's say it's 10 feet, you got to take away six to begin with, because that's 3 feet on one side, three on the other, that's 6 feet. That leaves, in a 10-foot wide kitchen scenario, a maximum of a 4-foot wide island, which, by the way, is a sizable width island, okay? So much so that I would say, as your designer, that I'd opt for the island going narrower to maybe closer to 3 feet, so that you get 3.5 foot of walk space all around, and then make the island as long as you need it to be. So just remember, you've got to have, in my view, a minimum of 36 inches all the way around this island. And when it comes to heavy cook zones, some place that you're going to put a cooktop on the island where you're going to be standing, or anywhere it is adjacent to a work or prep space, you may want more than 36 inches. So the question is then, you know, you measure out the kitchen and you figure out, wow, that thing's going to leave us an 18-inch wide island. Yeah, probably not a good justification for an island in that situation. A lot of people's kitchens, especially I find not so much 40s kitchens, which very rarely qualify for island space unless we're really throwing walls open. But I don't know, for whatever reason, 70s kitchens, they tend to be kind of open. You know, there's this sort of open floor plan to a 70s kitchen. And everybody just assumes, oh, we could fit an island in there. And as soon as you start measuring it, you realize, wow, this kitchen is larger than a galley, which makes it kind of awkwardly a far distance to walk from the fridge to the sink. And yet, it's too small, really, practically speaking, for a galley. So we put a lot of peninsulas in 70s kitchens because peninsulas just wrap the cabinets around that fourth wall. As opposed to dropping an island in the middle of the floor space, and then use islands in other applications. So those are the general rules, Kathy, and I hope that helps you out in regards to how to do the layout. And by the way, let me just throw this plug in here one more time. I understand you've called a contractor, and your contractor may have a lot of good advice, but let me just underscore, a builder, not a designer.
Come over here. Check it out.